Hi, I'm Dr. Hemant, Senior Consultant, Critical Care Services at Mazumdar Shaw Medical Center, Narayana Health City. I would like to take this opportunity to educate general public as to how to make use of the services that we provide here. By and large, I'm sure you have family doctors whom you visit when your near and dear ones are ill. However, there are some situations where you need to rush your near and dear ones to the ICU and emergency department, bypassing all those things. So there are some of the situations which I would like to mention are, like, if your near and dear ones is drowsy for any reason, not able to understand when you're trying to tell them, that is one situation. The other situation is where suddenly, you know, if they're unable to move their hands or legs, or if the face gets deviated to one side, that's again an emergency where you're not supposed to go first to a clinic and then come to the hospital. You need to rush directly to the hospital. And any chest pain which does not come down reasonably, okay, then there's sometime, you know, you need to rush, especially elderly people or who have diabetes, who are stressed, and if they develop chest pain, you have to rush them to the ICU immediately. And if you find that the way somebody is breathing is not good enough, we all know we are very comfortable with the way we breathe, the pattern we breathe, the rate at which we breathe. But when you look at your own near and dear ones and you see that their breathing way is not okay, either the rate is too high, the rate is too low, or the way the chest is moving is not good. And that's also an indication where you rush them to the nearest hospital and to the nearest emergency department. And if they are sweating excessively, or if you touch their hands and feet, if they're feeling cold, that's also one of the reasons where you have to rush them to the nearest hospital on an emergency basis. And loose motions, if they don't get controlled in few hours, that's also one of the reasons. And vomiting, if you are unable to control, and if you have a suspicion that they might have taken something, overdosed themselves, okay, this is another reason when you have to rush people. And when somebody falls down, okay, the most important thing you have to see is whether that fall was accidental, or whether it was following a trivial slip, or once they fall, whether they are able to remember what happened, or after they fall, if they develop any fits. If these are the situations where you have to rush the patient to the nearest emergency department and not to wait, or take it very lightly. And last but not least, if any time if you're feeling that your near and dear ones is not in their usual health condition, and you strongly believe, you know, in your inner heart that something drastic needs to be done and something is terribly wrong, listen to your inner voice and get them to an emergency department. Thank you.